Good morning, Bridges.
Today we're going to talk about where Jesus went when he was a boy. So in our yard, I've got four different places that he went, and I'm going to tell Madeline and Katrina to make different motions to get to those places. So first, and you can do these at home. So first, let's practice the motions. So I might say, let's swim. I might say, crawl. I might say, run with high knees. Or I might say, spin. Okay? So first, I want you to run with high knees to Jerusalem. Good. Now, swim to Bethlehem. Okay, now spin to Egypt.
Touch again.
Ooh, be careful.
Oh. Okay, now swim back to Bethlehem. And now crawl to Nazareth. Good job. Today is a special day called Palm Sunday. It is the week before Easter, which is the most important Sunday of the year for Christians, because Easter is the day that Jesus rises again from the dead. But Palm Sunday is the day that we wave palms and sing praise to God and say, thank you, God, for saving us. Because we are so thankful for God's love. So if you can ask your mommy or daddy to help you find a palm, or maybe you can make one, we have something online that will help you make one. You can just color it. But pause this video, get your palm, and then sing the songs and wave your palm and thank God for saving us.
Thank you.
If you ask Brandy and Amanda, missionaries in Sao Paulo, Brazil, what they think of the Brazilian people they have come to serve, they would say they are busy people, always at work, school, or sitting in traffic. But they would also tell you that Brazilians are energetic, loving, and kind.
That's Brazilians for me. They're just so incredible, but human in the end.
They just have such a hard time trusting anything that comes after something you say about Jesus. They already have this idea, this false idea of who he is, and there's nothing about Jesus that is life-giving to them.
You must not do this or that, and if you do that bad thing, then God will not love you. This judgment has kept me away from church and from God. There are many days that being missionaries in Sao Paulo is hard for Amanda and Brandy. They love the people in their city and want all their friends to know about Jesus and to choose him as their personal savior. But the girls know they cannot make people choose Jesus. It is their job to love their friends and to share the gospel with them and to trust that God can change their hearts.
I bet you've grown up a lot since you were a baby. Last week we talked about when Jesus was a baby. This week we're going to talk about when he was a boy. How do we know what Jesus was like when he was a child? We know from reading the Bible. The Bible is a special book that God gave us so that we could know about Jesus. And today as you listen to the story, I want you to think about how is Jesus like you? And how is Jesus not like you? Let's watch.
Hey, it's me, Megan, and this is Jesse. Jesse.
Hi. Hey, Megan, can you help me? I can't find Maya.
Who is Maya?
Maya is my new pet mouse.
I'm sorry, your pet what?
Mouse! Maya the mouse!
Why did you get a mouse for a pet?
Megan, Maya is so cute and cuddly. I can't wait for you to meet her!
Great.
Oh, I know where Maya is. She's at my house.
In her cage.
I forgot.
Oh well, guess I'll just have to meet Maya another time.
Yep. I'm so glad she isn't lost.
Hey, you know what? In today's Bible story, Mary and Joseph thought they had lost Jesus, but he wasn't lost at all. Listen to the Bible story to find out where Jesus was when Mary and Joseph found him.
After Jesus was born, wise men came to Bethlehem to worship him as king. When they left, an angel told Joseph in a dream to leave Bethlehem because King Herod wanted to hurt Jesus. So Mary, Joseph, and Jesus went to Egypt until Herod died. They went back to Israel and lived in Nazareth. Jesus grew up in Nazareth. Every year, Jesus' parents took a trip to Jerusalem for a special celebration called Passover. On Passover, the Jewish people got together to remember when God saved his people from slavery in Egypt. They celebrated all the things God had done for them. When Jesus was 12 years old, he went with Mary and Joseph to Jerusalem. After the celebration, Mary and Joseph started to go home. They traveled with a large group of people. But Jesus was not with them. Mary and Joseph thought that Jesus was somewhere in the group, but he had stayed behind in Jerusalem. Mary and Joseph walked for a whole day. Then they started looking for Jesus. They searched among their friends and family, but they could not find Jesus anywhere. Mary and Joseph hurried back to Jerusalem. They looked for Jesus, but they could not find him. Jerusalem was a big city, and Jesus was just a boy. Finally, Mary and Joseph found him in the temple. Jesus was listening to the teachers and asking them questions. The people were surprised at how much Jesus understood. Jesus' parents were surprised too. Mary said, "Son, why have you done this? Your father and I were worried. We've been looking everywhere for you." Jesus asked, "Why were you looking for me? Didn't you know that I had to be in my father's house?" Mary and Joseph did not understand what Jesus was talking about. Jesus went home with Mary and Joseph. He always obeyed them, and Mary remembered these things. Jesus grew taller and wiser. God was happy with him, and so was everyone who knew him. Jesus came to earth to do God's plan, and even as a boy, Jesus knew that. Jesus got ready to do what God sent him to do. God sent Jesus into the world to die on the cross and rescue people from sin.
While you were watching, did you think of any ways that you are like Jesus? He was a child, he had a family, and he traveled with his family. Did you think of any ways that Jesus is different from you? Well, he's God. That's really different. And because he's God, he lived his whole life and always obeyed his parents and always obeyed God. He never made a mistake. And because he was God, Jesus had a special purpose that God had given him. He was going to die for our sins. And you know, you're not Jesus, but you also have a special purpose that God has given you, and it's to tell others about God, that God is loving and good. And you can tell others that God knows you and that God saved you from your sin and that he wants to save others from sin. So you know what? You can invite people to church with you. You can invite them to watch these videos. You can tell them all about God. I'm praying for you, and we'll see you here next time.
Thank you. Thank you.